Hi everyone, welcome to Bikini Design Club. On today's tutorial, I will be explaining you how you can sew a zipper on the front of your lined swimsuits. So let's go ahead and start cutting the fabrics, getting the zipper, and doing the tutorial for you girls to see how you can secure the zipper between fabrics. Let's go! Today's video is actually part of the sew along for the swimsuit pattern Mary. And so if you want to sew Mary, you have the full tutorial separated in two parts and you can watch part one and then part two to sew the entire swimsuit. But I have shortened this and I made this smaller video only with the part of the zipper. So if you just want to check out how to sew the zipper with lining, let's follow this video. I hope you like it. Also went ahead and cut two stabilizer, which I found my white one. I still had a little bit, and I cut 3 centimeters high, so it's I will pop up how many inches because I'm not sure, but I will pop up how many they are. So it's 3 centimeters, and then I chose to make them 15 centimeters long, and I will pop up in inches how much that is. And I have two, one for the lining and one for the main fabric, so that it helps me stabilize the area where I'm gonna sew the zipper. But for now, let's sew the darts and the curved center back seams, and we will come back shortly. Now let's grab our front piece, and of course we can do this before sewing the darts because the fabric is plain on the table. But I did the darts today first, so it is what it is. Well, we should find the middle here, which you can do by placing the pattern on top and drawing a line in the middle. Or, of course, we can also fold the fabric and mark our middle, which I think it's what I'm gonna do today. When I cut the fabric, I remember that I wanted this drawing in the middle, so I know that that's just perfect. So I'm gonna repeat this on my lining and on my main fabric. I have my stabilizer fabric here, and I have drawn the line where it's the center where my zipper is going to be inserted, and I'm going to attach this here, but instead of sewing it, I'm going to use this one here, which is an adhesive for textiles from Mettler. And what I'm going to do is just place a little bit of this on this fabric, and then I'm gonna place this on top of the stabilizer on top of my main fabric. This is going to stick a little bit, but this is this is transparent. It is going to fade away once it's washed and everything, so that will be okay. And I don't need to use a lot. I just need to use enough to stabilize this in the correct spot. And I'm gonna repeat the process for my lining, for my main fabric. And then I'm going to measure. I want my zipper to be like 20 centimeters max. So I'm gonna measure from the edge there to the lower part here. I'm gonna measure 20, and I'm gonna mark that area here and on the main fabric. We are also going to draw the seam allowance on this area here. The seam allowance is included in the pattern, and it's 0.8 centimeters. So I'm just gonna draw here a guideline for my seam allowance. And again, the same here. Now I'm going to mark half a centimeter for this side and again on this side here. Like a box for the zipper. So let's prepare to sew the zipper. So I'm gonna draw a box where my zipper is going to be, and we had the center line, and then I designed another line that is 1/4 of an inch from my center line, from the edge, from the top edge here to the lower part, and the same on this side. On the lower part here, I'm going to draw two lines on the lower part here to create a placket so that the zipper edge here can be placed to the other side, okay? So I'm going to measure 0.6 centimeters again here, so 1/4 of an inch. And now I'm gonna draw aligning the top edge here with the seam allowance a little bit below, just on the line, and I pinned it in place. And when I reach the bottom part here, I'm gonna be sewing the zipper until the line that I've drawn there before with chalk, you almost can't see it, but it's there, it's here where I've placed my last pin, which is aligns with the edge of this clip here that we did when we cut the area for the zipper, okay? So sew until you reach that area there, from the top edge to the lower part here, using your zipper foot. So I have stitched this with my white thread, and I was thinking lately that there's another way I can do this. Maybe in the future I would do it differently, but let's go ahead and do this with this method today. So I have sewn until I reached the edge here, as I told you, one side of my main fabric, so my zipper is in place on this side. And now we need to repeat the process for our second side. So if my zipper is going to be like so, so if this was to be like this, we need to flip it and secure it in place and pin it just like we did on the other side. As on the other side, I'm gonna see where my seam allowance is. I'm gonna place a pin here so that I can see it on this side. And now I'm going to align the top edge of my zipper with my seam allowance. Just the exact same thing we did when we sewed the other sides of the zipper, okay? Now you see this small bit that is sticking to this side? We will pull it to the wrong side, so to the inside of the fabric, and we will sew that small area in place and it will be done. I will think, I already know another way that we could do this, because this is usually, you see like a little bulkiness on the edge here. This is very hard. And it's very hard to be perfect, but I think I will try again with a different method, and if it works I will put it on camera for you girls. But for now, I just took that small triangle inside, and you can see that it's here on this side, right? So I just need to lay it flat and go to my sewing machine and stitch straight over the zipper. Since this is a zipper, a metal zipper, I will go and use a very thick needle so that I don't break my needle when going over the zipper, okay? And I'm gonna go from one side to the other until that is secure, and then I can put this on the right side and it will be finished on the sides, of course, on the insertion of the zipper on the main side. Then we will do exactly a very similar process to include our lining. But let's move on and do what I've just told you and sew this small bit here. Now we are gonna sew again. Now we are including the lining, and we will sew again at the zipper in this area here. And when we reach more or less here, we will stop. We will move the Of course, we should have cut the two small edges that we did, like we did here, to create a triangle, which I was lazy and I didn't. And now that this is a huge chunk here, when I put it on the correct, you can see that it's a lot of bulkiness because I even overcut the straight line, and then I had to correct it with a small zigzag to connect the fabric. This will be on the inside, but I don't want all this bulkiness here, so I'm gonna cut slightly the fabric here and on this side also to release the tension that is around here. But my recommendation is that the same that we did for this one, we should have done it for this one. I was lazy, sorry. Now, before I can finish the edge here, so that this is just perfect, we need to combine our back pieces. So I'm gonna connect the shoulders, right sides facing together, for the main fabric and also for the So now that we have all the neckline ready to be sewn, because we have sewn the shoulder area, we can finally hide this and sew these two together. You want to sew this placing them right sides facing together. So that's what I'm going to show you. If you are like so, and if you move them right sides facing together and you start pinning, you will then go all around your neckline and you will enclose your zipper on the seam allowance. I'm going to pin all around and I'm going to apply elastic on the side of my main fabric all around my neckline. So with our elastic sewn in place, all our top edge neckline is sewn, and we can now move on to the next things. Well, let me just talk to you about some details. In the beginning here, near the zipper, I used a straight stitch just to make sure that I kept the seam allowance very sharp, and I'm now going to reinforce and fade that seam allowance with a zigzag in this area here, because afterwards I'm gonna cut the corner here. This, all of this is going to be cut so that when I reverse this to the right side, it will look great. And we will do exactly the same on the other side, okay? So let's do that for now. So when we reinforce this corner here, we are not only reinforcing the corner, but we are making sure that the threads from the overlock will not come out once we trim this that I've just trimmed, because you have secured them with your stitch, so they are secure, okay? I'm gonna repeat this on the other side. I'm also going to trim this because we don't need this much stabilizer here, so I can cut it. Once everything is trimmed, you can see when you turn it to the right side that your zipper edge is ready and you have your zipper between your two fabrics. And that's it, our zipper is done, and we can go ahead and follow the rest of the tutorial if you want to sew the swimsuit pattern Mary. That will be it for today, girls. See you soon, bye!